welcome back, which should be the last video for the application of the masking kit and the paint design that we came up with this to match the movie model. This is for the Kronos 1 model, the 1/350 scale. And we'll get started with right away on starting to paint a few little areas. We're going to start off with the red. We need to paint a lot of this aft area. We've got some masking that's going to go in the front. If you want to look at the photos of the original ship, you can see what we have to do here. We have these grills in the back that have to be painted. There's some sections up front, a middle section on the front, same on the side. And then on the bottom, we've got a section here that's got to be red and a section here. Now, they don't have the raised panels on the model, so just spray this area red, and then we'll show you where to lay in the masks for that. Also, we've got this hatch cover, I think, from the top of the main system or the main ship. That this little area here is going to be red, so we'll paint that up red. And then I'm going to move these out of the way. Okay, there's a couple pieces we placed on the model before painting them, and if you do the same thing we have done, we have masked out now that go over these. If not, if you painted these sections here on the forward pylon red, then you're good. You can just paint those red and glue them on after. But we have a little masking kit for that, just because we made the mistake and we figured someone else will be doing that too. And all that is, that's found on sheet 4. And all that it's just an outside template. And one side has a point on it. The point goes towards the center of the ship. So all you do is just lay this over top. It fits like we did the medallion on the bottom. And then we can just paint all that red, and that fixes up our problem. I'm not going to paint that red right now. I'm going to wait till we actually paint this edge. I think this edge is supposed to be the light gray. I might paint that light gray, and then I'll do that red after. But I'll get the other parts all painted up, and then we'll come right back and continue on. Okay, so we got our red painted. I guess what I should do is not attach this piece. But I just wanted to try and get as much done as I could, so we might have to tape that off when we're doing the gray, but that's okay. We've got lots of everything here, so. All right, so we're going to mask this stuff off, and what we're going to do is we're going to go to sheet 2 for this area. And all that is, that's just a single piece. And all we need to do is just start right where the 45 stops and the straight line starts. Just right in there. Pretty simple. That'll be that. Now on the aft part, these little grill areas, we use the blue for the grills. Those are found on sheet 1 again. You can kind of see where they fit. They kind of go, according to the model, this first solid piece is red and the back solid piece is red. You can just kind of put that right on top, and that'll keep all that. And then the other piece, same thing, the solid section here is red, so we'll just follow that right on the top. Okay, now these pieces on here we did in black, because the black, like we said before, it tends to conform to more of these bumps that are on here, so that will help you out. The blue doesn't tend to stick as well for that. So on the black sheet, you get this little piece here, which goes on the front. Again, like before, I'm going to reposition these once I get off camera, because it's hard. I don't want to put my head in the camera, so I'm just kind of showing you pretty much where they go. And they're in the same area that they need to be. So you just follow around. So this next one's going to go right here. That should follow the raised area that they've provided. The one on the other side, same thing. Now with the black, before you seat it right down, just kind of maneuver around till you get it where you got it and or where you need it. And then once everything's in shape, then push it down and it'll conform to everything. I'm not going to do that right now. I'll show you after, once we get to the painting stage. Like I said, I need to reposition mine. This piece right here, just sits right up against the in there. The aft two pieces. Okay. Into this side. Okay, in the bottom section, if you go to the pictures of the original ship, these are the ones we've done here. There's no grooves underneath here that are in this right position, because this is the old Katinga mask, or the old Katinga ship. So on sheet one, we provide you the blue sections, because these will lay flat. And all we want to do is you can just see where these, wherever these laser things are, we just want to be kind of right in there. And then it just goes right to the tip of where this 45 starts. That's kind of the where we can see it's got to be. And then you can put that in place. And then same for the other side. Again, just kind of look at the side you just did and kind of copy that. Same with the ones on the aft. Now, there's no place for us to start. So we've kind of figured out where we think it should go. Okay, and these pieces on the aft section here, there's no raised areas for those. We did some on sheet one. And all you gotta do is, it looks like they're close to this little section right here. So we've just come up with a plan to put one in here. So just go against the ribbed area here, the ridged area. Lay it in there. And then just copy what you did on this side, on the other side. Okay, so I've got all the masking on this bridge area here. You can see how the black kind of, once you press it down, it does conform to all the little bumps and protrusions that the ship has. So one note, when you're repositioning the masking, especially the black one, don't push it down like this, because now if you were to lift this off and try and reposition this is going to stretch out of shape. And then you're going to have to come up with your own little area for this. So just lightly tap it in when you're positioning it. And then once you think you've got it exactly, then you can press it all down. Okay. So the next color we need to do is the tan. And there's some tan on this. But what we want to do is, there's some areas here on the nacelles we have to deal with first. Like I said, there's glass here, and there's just no way of creating mass that will fit in here that got to sit down about a 60th of an inch and sit on top of the corrugated glass. It's never going to work for you. So what I suggest is keep these pieces separate. These little recesses here have to be that brownish gray color that we're painting. So what we're going to do is, we're going to paint this first. Now, you can either paint those in with a brush if you want. We have created masks for this, except for these two little ones in the very front. That's almost impossible. We have a mask for this one at the back. It's the smallest mask we've ever created, and it does fit in there. These two, you're probably gonna have to take a toothpick and shave it to a point and take a little bit of the brown once you've painted everything, and just dab that in there. So we're gonna paint this brown, and then once we come back, we'll put the mask on. Then we're gonna paint this tan, this ornament around here. So once we're doing that tan, then we're gonna go back to this and paint tan, just so we're not moving paint around the gun. We keep everything going. So I'm gonna give this a shot of the dark brown or the dark brown gray, and I will be right back. Okay, so we got our brown gray all painted on, and I also painted this front piece. That's also brown gray. The thing is we're trying to get you clear this area here so you can actually assemble. Now once we finish the painting here, then you can put all the glass together, your lighting, whatever you're going to do, then put this together. There's going to be a lit area in the front here. That's why I'm thinking if we paint these now. But then once you put all this together, you're going to have to fill all the seams, sand it all down, and then repaint again. But at least this area here will be good for you. So this area, and then you can move on. So what we're going to do is, we're going to put the masks. We don't need anything more done on those. We're going to put the masks on these guys. Okay, and these masks are found on sheet one. And I'm just going to cut them out of here. Again, just bend and pull one off. And they sit right inside. These definitely I'm going to have to reposition once I get the magnifying lamp on. Because it's really hard to see without putting your head right over top of it and having lots of light. And the smallest mask we've ever created. There it is. The smallest one. Alright, well, get that positioned. We're going to do that, and then we're going to paint some tan. This whole area here is going to be all painted tan, and on the bridge area, this one section here is going to be tan. This section here is going to be tan. All right. Well, I'm going to get all that masking on, give that a shot of paint, and I'll be right back. Okay. So we gave the front bridge area a couple coats of the tan that was on this. Sorry, there was actually one more I missed. There was actually this one here, like we talked about this one, and then there's this little guy right on the top. And then when you've got all that done, you can go to your black sheet, and on there we should have the black mask that will go on top of that. Start this at the bottom and follow the grid line up and just roll to that edge. And this side. You can go either way. You can start on the back edge too. Why don't you start on one, follow the grid line up. And just tap it into place. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to take our light gray or our white gray, the white gray that we mix, and we're going to make it just a little bit darker. We're actually going to call it a light gray too, and that's this whole section right in here is going to go light gray too. So I'm going to give that a shot and I will be right back. Okay, so we gave this front edge that light gray too, and also on the black page is where you're going to find the cover for that one. This one's got a split in it, and you're just going to start this in the center and move to one side, and then following down the grid line, and then lifting this one up, because this is why it's split, because it's too hard to do as one piece. Okay, so you got that piece down, and we do the same thing. We just follow this one along the line on the top edge, then down the grid, and then it's cut a little longer so it'll fit right over top of that one. All right, so that's done. So now we're going to paint all of this, our light gray, other than this round area here and this side. But we'll do that, and then we also got to now paint. We have to paint this area here light gray. So we'll paint that light gray, and then I'm going to get the masks on here, because now that we've painted the tan on here, we're going to put masks on here, and then these will be painted the light gray. So we'll paint everything at once, and we'll continue on from there. I'll be right back. Okay, so found on sheet 3, you're going to find a little mask for covering that up, this one right here. Now it's going to go right over top of this whole stuff here in the center. Okay. Now I'm just going to bring this back in. So what we're doing is we're actually creating this little area right in here that has the dark brown gray. Then this will be the tan, and then we're going to paint this area here all the light gray. That will allow you to then take this and assemble your glass inside here, your light kit, and get all that ready, and then you can seam seal all this. And then once we've got all that done, we're gonna do it too. Then we'll come back and we'll finish painting that up. All right. All right. Well, we got our light gray painted on the nacelles and this bridge area and the top. We're gonna just pull the masking off. So like I said, this is all you really want to do with this. This just kind of helped you if you're lighting your kit or you're gonna be moving forward with something else on it. So at least it's you've got this section part of or this. Paint job done. All right, so that would be that one. This one. Like I said, all you'll have to do is there's two little points on the end here on both sides that are the same brown. You'll have to just use a toothpick or something to get in there. So that'll be that. So these ones, we're going to go ahead and assemble these, and then we'll come back and finish painting out those. Now this area here is pretty much done, so we can kind of get rid of this stuff. Well, there it is. I'm just gonna have to repaint all this red again, but that's all right. All right, and then for this one, we're gonna have to put a cover on here found on sheet two. It's got the side with the two notches goes to the front here. So all I do is just start this right at the back. And then move yourself forward. And then this is all gonna get painted now that browny gray color. So that's this. So that now we're just gonna paint all this, the brown gray. And then we'll be right back. All right, so we applied the blackish brown to this, like the hatch cover at the on the main ship. So, and that's all painted, so that's done. So now what we've done here is we went through all the steps here to do all this and paint this the light gray inside. And then there's two masks that you get that you put over top here, and they just kind of cover that square block area. And mask for the front, because we painted this that the brown too. The reason being is, so now for those of you who are lighting this model or doing the glass work inside and you don't want to get paint on it, what this allows you to do is now we can assemble the nacelles. Like the previous step, we were just doing them in halves, but now you can put them together and finish all your edges or seam filling and prime everything again and get it ready. This will protect these areas from any of the putty or any of the primer you're gonna spray over top of that. Now it can continue on. So what we're gonna do, okay, so the next step we're gonna do is we're gonna paint this little area right in here on the inboard side of the nacelles. It's going to be that black kind of color we did for the grills on the engineering section on the aft of the main ship. It's kind of a mixture of black and brown, so I'm going to give these a shot, and then once we're done we have masking that goes over top of that to protect that, and that's all found on sheet six. So I'm going to get all that done and I'll be right back. Okay, so we applied our black brown color and then put our masking on. That's the masking that's found on sheet six. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna continue on with the top. So what we have to do now, I'm gonna put this one aside because I just painted that the primer on that, so I don't wanna put masking on that right away. But we can work on this one because this one's done. So what we need to do now is we need to paint the tan, and the tan is gonna go on this whole top area, this bottom area, you can see here, and then we're gonna be covering it with the blue and black mask, because once the blue mask worked fine here on the spine, but once they get to here where you've got a curve going down and a curve going left and right, they don't work very well. So the black ones will be better for that. So we're going to go ahead and paint all this tan, and we'll come right back and we'll apply the mask to it. Okay, well, we painted our tan on the top and the bottom of the nacelle, so we're going to get ready to mask that off. And we're going to go to our black sheet, and our black sheet, you're going to have all the masks for that. There is some difference in the mask, so they're pretty easy to follow. This one's got the longer line, this one's got the shorter line. So basically what we're doing is we're going to start, actually I'm going to grab a, it's probably easier if you see it this way. We're going to start right here in this corner, right here. I'm going to just tap that in place. And get that side in, move around to the front. Now I can see my center line because I haven't got the seams exactly the way they should be, so I will fix that later, but I think just so we can get the video out, we'll leave it the way it is. Okay, so that's that side. And like I said before, if the black is a little bit more stickier than the blue, so if you want to take a little tact off, go ahead, see how it works for you. Same thing, start in the same corner but on the other side. Just overlap them just a little bit so you don't have a line there, unless you want to fix it up with a little bit of tape or something. Like I said, I'm not going to press these down real hard because I need to adjust them later on. So that's the bottom ones, or the top ones, and the bottom ones. Now these, I found the best place to start these is right down here, kind of get this in place to where this looks like it's going to fit. And then move your way around the front and fold it over. The other side. Start the same way. Now the rest of these we can do in blue. They're found on sheet 6. And there is difference on these. If you look, they're on the forward side. This side is longer, this side is shorter. So these you can start right at the bottom. And then there's a line that runs right along here is a good line to align that to. And then let that fall into place. Same location. And see how it matches here. If it doesn't match perfectly, then just check your alignment on the mask. Make sure you got everything where it's supposed to be. Probably have to adjust that one. This kind of gives you the idea what we're doing here. All right, I can already see this is not right, so let's try this from the back. There we go. Okay. And you got the two front pieces. Pretty much start them where you want. They pretty much fit where they're supposed to, so whatever is easier for you guys. Okay. All right, so once you've got all that done, what we're gonna do is, let me grab the sheets here. So once we've done all our black and blue on top, bottom, we're gonna move on to the red section. Now the red is this tail section here. These are what you need to paint. Now we built a mask for these. They don't fit. They fit really well. They're not as accurate. I made them a little bit longer, so it kind of covers the seams. But you'll see how these go on here. But we're gonna paint this back part here red. Not this part yet. I think it's easier to paint these. Then we paint the whole thing silver, and then we bring the red in on the backside. So I'm gonna do that, get all this cleaned up, and then I'm gonna paint all these red, and I'll come right back. The red has now been applied and dried. We're gonna start applying these masks on the back. You just have to follow the way they are. They are outlined on the instruction guide of whether they're port or starboard, so you'll be able to figure that out. And then look for these notches. That'll tell you which group of three fit in that area. And the notches are for this piece here and this piece here. One of them is the notch is a little bit forward for this one. This one, the notch is a little bit aft for that one. But basically all you do is you just find the one you need. And then if you want to take the tacked off the black, go ahead. And all you do is you just line this one up. Kind of fits right down in there. And like I said, these are cut a little bit longer so that you can actually fold them over. And then once you've found that one, then this one you just kind of start near the back. You can go right over top of the mask just a little bit, just so you don't have a seam. And then right to the edge, and then that goes all the way over the edge, over the top, okay? And then the front one just starts. Okay, you might need to reposition these or just put a little piece of masking tape over that. So there's that one, and then there's one for this side, and this side. So I'm gonna go ahead and get those on, and we'll be right back. Okay, well, we got all our black protective masks on. They're actually not that bad. Once you get going on, they're pretty easy and they fall right into place. You can see that, you don't have to press them down really hard. They're just there to protect the red. They're there to, you could mask them off, but this way we just did something and maybe gave you a little bit of help. So if there's an area that you have to add a little piece of masking tape after the fact, that's not a big deal. We've kind of helped you out a little bit, so that'll be that. So what we're going to do now is we're going to paint all of the nacelles all the light gray now that everything's all masked and covered. So I'm going to spray all that out and we'll come right back. Okay, so we got all the light gray painted on, and what I did is I just removed this mask here just to make sure I had it all the way around. I guess if when you're doing this the previous step, if we paint more the light gray, then you'll be fine, good to go. And rather than removing all the masking that's already protecting paint, then I just took some of that blue mask that we had on, I think it was sheet two. I just wrapped it around the edge of this back part and then gave it some tape and gave everything a paint of red. And then we should be good to go to start removing all the masks. Now there will be some touch-up paint you'll have to do because there's just no way of doing around the mask, and that's like this little pipe that's here supposed to be the light gray. So as long as you're keeping some of that in reserve, you can paint that, and then also this pipe here. I tried to cover as much as I could, but there's a section right here that needs to be painted. But that's nothing, that's just a little bit. At least this helped you out most of the way. All right, well, there's one of the nacelles done. Like I said, might have a little bit of touch up where the mask, I didn't push down hard enough. While I was painting the light gray on these, I also painted these things, these pieces that need to be light gray, and then I also painted these pieces, kind of a mixture of a gray and a zinc color, and then I can get all those assembled. So we'll get all that assembled and I'll be right back. Okay, well, we got our nacelles all assembled and painted, cleaned up. I gave these things a coat of flat just to protect all the paint. Put all these ribs in, and Probably some of you are going to ask, what's with this green? Did I leave green tape in there? No, I just painted the glass kind of mine's a non-lit model, so I thought if I at least paint it green, it looks like it's that's what the color is supposed to be when it's lit. All right, so we're going to move on. And a couple other things we're doing here is we're going to be doing the inside of the pylons and the exterior side of the pylons. So what I've done is I painted the inside of the pylons a medium gray, and then I've also painted the insides of here a medium gray, because we have a mask that goes over that you'll be able to find on sheet 2. That'll cover that up, so then when you paint all this light gray, those will stay medium gray. But we'll work on this these areas here, and these will be found on sheets 2 and 3. Okay, the pieces again are just laid out the same way they will be on the pylon. And like I said, we painted all this the medium gray. All we're going to do is we're just going to cover up areas here where the grids are. All right, well, that's the inside of that done. So now what we're going to do is, now that the medium gray is protected, we're going to give this a coat of the light gray. And I'll come right back and I'll also give this a shot of the light gray. All right, well, we gave this all these inboard pylons a coat of the light gray. Now we're just going to remove the mask. Okay, so the inboard pylons are done. We're going to move on to the outboard pylons. And the first thing we want to do is we want to spray the dark brown on these long kind of rectangle areas. So we're going to spray that out and we'll come right back. Okay, well, we got the dark brown painted on both outboard pylons, and go back to sheet 2 and 3. We will find the mask for those. Just kind of start it in the corner, right along the grid line. I don't know if you can see that, I'm trying to keep this up, but it's a little hard to hold right now. Okay, so now we're gonna do is, now we're gonna paint these two little areas back here tan, and then we'll come back and we'll mask those over. Okay, well, we got our tan paint on, and now we're gonna put a mask over that, found on sheet 2 and 3. This one, just start in the top here, work this side and then down. Okay. And the other side. Okay. Now we got to paint a forward edge here red, and then we have a mask that will cover that one. So we'll paint the forward edge on both sides red, and we'll be right back. Okay, so our red paint's been applied, and we're going to apply the mask on it. So we'll just go back to sheet 2 for this side. And there's a thick side and a thin side. The thick side goes right up against top of the wing and just rides along the outside edge all the way down. Now, it doesn't go all the way down to the bottom, neither does the model or the movie model. So okay, and then on sheet 3, right up against the top and along the outside edge. Okay, now we're going to paint this whole area in here a gray that's just a little darker than our body light gray. So I think it's light gray 2 is what we had for that. So I'm gonna spray these out and then we'll be right back. Okay, well, our light gray 2 is painted on here, and now we're going to put the last masking sets on that on the pylon. All right. Sorry, I have to prop this up so you can see what we're doing here. Okay, so this one here, we're going to start kind of down here and work our way along this grid line. And that's going to come down here. That's going to go up this way. And each time you can move it a little bit, it will take a little bit of movement. So, but it should be pretty close to fitting almost right on the nose. So, not much adjustment on that one. That one fits right in. All right, well, I'm going to do the other side. Now what we do is we give this a final coat of our light gray base color, and then we can pull all the masking off. I'll be right back. Okay, well, we did our final coat of the light gray, and we can remove all the tape and masking and see what it looks like. There you go. Subtle, but that's the way it was on the filming model, so that's the way we got here. All right, well, I'll take the rest off and we'll continue on. Okay, well, with that, it looks like the masking instruction videos have been completed. We're gonna go ahead and start doing some of the decals here and see how all those fit, start doing some assembly, and then like we said at the very beginning, these are the colors that we've chosen. If I'm curious to see what you guys come up with, as everyone's perception of color is different. So at least this is a good starting point for you. Please post your bills on the Facebook page so we can see how yours is going and what colors you came up with. And yeah, we'll continue on with this, and then we'll probably hopefully get a video with the weathering that we're going to try on this kit. And other than that, I think that's it. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the build.